Today on Typical Books, we're going to be talking about some of the books that I've read recently and what's coming up on the show. I also picked up a few extra books last time I went to a thrift store. So yeah, those who follow my Instagram have seen that I am reading Heads Will Roll by Josh Winning. I never read Burn the Negative, and I was interested in it, and I love the cover. I love the cover of this book even more. And I've been really enjoying it so far, so hopefully I'll be reviewing it. It was a patron pick, so I'm definitely going to be reviewing it. There's a few points in the book where I just find that the lead character is like, oh, coming from a place that's a little younger, like a school clown, and it's kind of weird, but we'll see. I'm barely into the book, only a few chapters really, so we'll see if that smooths over or if it becomes something, part of the plot that works for me, or for it more accurately. I've got my bookmark in here, it's making a bunch of noise, so I didn't pick it up right away. But yeah, I'm quite a bit farther in than I thought I was, page 66, so I don't know, a quarter of the way through the book. Really liking it so far. It's very summery, very camp, very campy. It's very, it's an adult horror book so far. It just seems that the younger person in it is skewing younger than I would have expected for an adult summer camp. It's not really YA, but we'll see as the story progresses. It wouldn't be inappropriate at this point yet for a younger audience. Speaking of inappropriate for a younger audience, I read Cannibals. It is wildly inappropriate for a younger audience. It's maybe inappropriate for a fully adult audience too, but oh, so much fun. If you like Richard Layman and that sort of like pulpy horror, that more extreme type of horror, and if you can't get enough of The Hills Have Eyes and Offspring and the whole Sonny Bean mythology, this is the book for you. And it reads a lot like, what if Sonny Bean happened in X year. So yeah, Guyon Smith is quite famous as far as pulpy horror goes. I've not read any of his other books until now, so I'm very pleased to have this. And yeah, if you had tuned in to the patron only podcast, I talked about some of my favorite things. One of my favorite things lately is the channel Night Nerves, and he's also reading this. So yeah, you'll hear more about Cannibals, I'm sure, there. But I really, 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 really enjoyed this. But you know, I do like Richard Layman quite a bit, and it reminded me a lot of if he was writing from Scotland a few years prior. I've also just finished reading, well, I've also just finished reviewing, because I read it and then I'm going to reread some portions again when I review this book very soon. Midwestern Gothic by Scott Thomas comes out next month. So yeah, I'll be very excited to be talking about this very, very soon. And it was on the list of horror books coming out in September, of course. I've been looking forward to talking about this one for quite a bit because I really enjoyed it. That was a review copy, and there's another review copy in the works, of course, with Keeper of the Key by Nicole Wilson, which I'm looking forward to. It comes out about the same time. And I'll be reading the Garbology collection as well. That is the Criminology Presents, a anthology of awesome trash. So yeah, that will be some of my reading coming up. So I did pick up a couple books last time I went to a thrift store, and I check out the thrift store near me for clothes from time to time, for like houseware goods. You might think that I've been picking up things from thrift stores if you see some of these new knickknacks that I've got, but these are actually antiques from my grandma's collection, from my mother's things, that I've been putting on the shelves. But yeah, I wish that I could find this kind of cool stuff when I go thrifting, but I do check out the books, even though there's not ever a lot of horror there. I look just in case. What I'm really looking for when I go there, I think, is a copy of Michelle Remembers. That's what I went for the last time and a couple visits before that, and I'm just going to keep visiting this particular thrift store because it's the closest one to me, and it is a Christian-run thrift store as well, like a lot of them are. But yeah, so I found Stephen King, The Gunslinger. I do have the Plume version of the first and third book. I need the second book in that, but I picked this up because I have the second and third book in this format. I've been listening to Jason from Jason's Weird Reads and Sin from Sin's Book Nook talk about the Gunslinger series, and that's been fantastic. So I've started flipping through this as they talk, especially when there's things that I don't quite remember because it's been many years. So I'm going to be rereading this, probably the Plume editions, although these are very convenient to take to work. Just a little oddity, I found a copy of The Tales of Beedle the Bard by J.K. Rowling, and this goes along with my not having ever read this before. And if you've watched the films or read the books or played the game, there's some little tiny snippets that come from this. So I figured I'd pick it up, I'd read it, and then throw it in the unhaul box, which is growing. Look, that was a whole bunch to get rid of still. I was super pleased to find this little copy of Frankenstein by Mary Shelley, and it is a Wordsworth edition. It's a hardcover, but it is printed. I forget that sort of process where they've printed the same cover on the dust jacket onto the book. So it's not fabric bound or anything nice like that. It's just press board, but who knows? I don't know. I like it. I have a couple copies of Frankenstein, one on the shelf right behind me in paperback, which I wouldn't want to carry around because it is kind of old. This is just a great little copy that I can keep on my reading shelf beside where I normally read and pick it up if I ever need to. I don't think this will become like my copies of Dracula, where I seem to collect copies of Dracula now, and I think I will continue. I've just embraced it. I collect copies of Dracula. So maybe I will also begin to collect copies of Frankenstein, who knows, but yeah, Dracula. Maybe I'll do a video about the Dracula collection so far. And because it is a Christian thrift store, we have American Exorcism, Expelling Demons in the Land of Plenty by Michael W. Caneo. And this is a nonfiction book, long form journalism, the way I like it. And I've wanted to read more long form journalism, nonfiction books. And this sounds really cool. It's a lot older than I thought. I think it was 2006 or something like that. I thought it was at least in the 2020s this was written, if not like late 2010s, but it's a lot older than I thought, and I'd never heard of it. It's just in really good condition. So barely looks red, actually. A little bit of wear from being slid off and on a shelf. It's probably been at that thrift store for a bit, really. But yeah, very pleased to get a very nice nonfiction book to add to my spooky reading that's going to be coming up soon. Much like most of my nonfiction reading, I think that that will just sit alongside Frankenstein on the table near where I read, where I can pick it up here and there. I really like doing that with Naomi Klein's books, just picking them up when I want a change of pace. In between books, I'll probably read a few chapters, so I really do enjoy that. Have any of those found their way off or onto your shelves? Let me know in the comments below. Of course, big love for Frankenstein. I'm sure a lot of us have read that. And is there a book like Frankenstein or Dracula that you collect? Let me know in the comments. Thank you ever so much for watching, and have an oogie spooky day.